Hello, my dear students. Welcome you all to botany class. In a previous class, we have discussed about various food plants like cereals, pulses, also about the sugarcane, right? In today's class, we shall discuss about next type of the economic crop, that is fiber crops, means the plants which yield fibers. Okay, the fiber mainly used for the purpose of making cloths and ropes, any purpose of fiber. We will be discussing about two examples under fiber crops. One is cotton, other one is jute. All of you know that cotton is one of the major economic or financial crops of India, right? So also a part of our economic botany, right? We shall see one by one with their details. Right, first one, the cotton. The botanical name, that is Gossypium. Species means there are many species: Gossypium herbaceum, Gossypium arboreum. Like that, there are various species of the genus Gossypium, and it belongs to the family Malvaceae. And vernacular names, there are many vernacular names, many common names as per many languages. Okay, so we shall see the details first. Description: it is also known as white gold since it is white in color. Also, it is a very much costly even for the farmers since it is in very much demand of the cloths. It is one of the most important commercial crops and plays a key role in economic, political and social affairs of the world, and of course our India. Means since it is very much economical for the farmers, and many the textile industries are depending on the cotton, hence it will make difference in economic, political as well as a social affairs, right? And here India ranks first in the world in area and third in total production of the cotton. Okay, and its natural fibers are the most important raw materials for comfort clothing production. Comfort clothing, okay, whichever the cloths we are wearing now, it's all made of only the cotton, right? So this is the cotton plant with a yellow colored flowers. Looking at the original distribution, the existence of cotton threads is mentioned in the Rigveda, in the old Indian scripture, around 1500 BC, and it finds references in ancient Greek and Roman literature. And here the India remained chief center of cotton industry for over 3000 years, from 1500 BC to AD 1500. Okay, and its natural fibers are the most important raw materials for comfort clothing production. Okay, so few more points about distribution. Very soft and fine Indian cloth known as dukka muslin was renowned all over the world in the old times, and cotton was introduced from India eastward to China and westward to Egypt around 600 AD, and mainly the Arab traders introduced cotton to the African continent. Arab traders visited India and the other African continents, so they have introduced from India to the African continent, and cotton is now cultivated in about 60 countries of the world. Okay, and looking at the plant characters, plants botanical or morphological characteristics. The plant is annual or perennial shrub. Shrub means medium sized plant, attaining height of 1 to 2 meter, and the leaves are simple and palmately lobed, each with two lateral stipules at the base. Means the leaf has two lateral stipules, small leaf like structure, and the flowers are solitary, single, axillary, in the axil of the leaf and stem, regular and bisexual. It has both antrosium and gynoecium, and they are large and showy with a yellow corolla and crimson red gynoecium. Corolla is yellow colored, petals are yellow colored, and the gynoecium is a crimson red. Okay, few more characteristics. The calyx is cup shaped with a 5 persistent sepals, and the corolla has 5 petals which are connate at the base, fused at the base. And there are numerous connate stamens which form staminal tube. Remember, staminal tube is a main character of the family Malvaceae. Means the many filaments of all the anthers fuse to form a tube over the style. Okay, filaments of all the anthers fuse together to form a tube on the style of the gynecium. Hence, it is called a staminal tube, tube made up of stamens. Okay, the gynecium is composed of 3 to 5 syncarpous carpels, and the superior ovary is 3 to 5 locular. Okay, here you can see the plant Gossypium hirsutum, Gossypium arboreum. Okay, these are the two different varieties of the cotton plant. Looking at the uses, cotton is known for its versatility, performance and natural comfort, and it is used to make all kinds of cloths and home wares, as well as for industrial purposes like tarpaulins, tent, hotel suits, army uniforms, etc. And the cotton fibers can be woven or knitted into fabrics such as velvet, cadwari, chambray, velour, jersey and flannel. Many types of cloths can be manufactured by using the cotton. Okay, and in addition to textile products like underwear, socks, etc., many more products are produced. Cotton is a food and a fiber crop. Okay, cotton seed is fed to the cattle and crushed to make oil. Seeds are the good source of water for the animals, and cotton seed oil is used for cooking and in products like soap, margarine, emulsifiers, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, rubber and plastics. So cotton has got a wide range of applications in many fields. Of course, main field is textile, but other than textile, the cotton has got various applications. Okay, the second fiber crop, that is jute. Okay, so looking at the details, it's local, it's called Tosa Pat, Sada Pat, etc. And English name jute, scientific name Corchorus auliturius. White jute, it is called Corchorus capsularis linens. Family belongs to the Tilaceae. Okay, and jute is a type of vegetable fiber used to make items such as rope, twine, carpet, rugs and much more. And here jute is one of the cheapest and strongest of all natural fibers and considered as a fiber of the future. Okay, compared to cotton, even jute is the strongest fiber, naturally available fiber, hence it is called a fiber of the future. Okay, so raw jute is the natural fiber which is extremely eco-friendly, means it has no manufacturing or extracting complexity. So it is called a golden fiber, means it is more costly than cotton, means it is called golden colored but costly, golden fiber. Okay, and Bangladesh is the biggest producer of the natural jute or raw jute fiber, both in quantity and quality. Bangladesh heads it. Looking at the origin, several historical documents during the era of Mughal Emperor Akbar state that villages like Bengalian villages, India is the main origin of this jute. Bangladesh, Bengali, almost they are all nearby. You can see the fiber, since it is pure gold colored, it is called a golden fiber. Okay, looking at the description of the plant, here the botanical description of the jute plant is as follows. Plant, it is an annual herb, it is a tall, slender, half shrubby, means shrub like, nearly 2 to 3 meters of height, more than cotton. And stem is long, slender and color varies from a full green to dark red branched. Okay, and roots, are well developed, well branched and having taproot system. Leaf is simple and petiolate. Flowers are small and yellow in color. Fruit is capsule pod around the pod in the species capsularis, elongated in the Corcorus olidorius. Yield, when we look at the weight of the plant, weight of the jute is different. So, green plant weight yield is 45 to 50 tons per hectare, but fiber yield is 2 to 2.5 tons per hectare, but other is just waste material. Looking at the applications, the fiber is used of household, many domestic and decorative purposes like ropes, sacks, bags, blanket, twine, yarn, rugs, hessian, cloth, wall mats, and now it's used to produce CBC yarn and jutex yarn by blending with cotton fiber. Nowadays, green jute is used to produce paper. Okay, and young shoots leaves can be eaten by cooked, when they are cooked. Okay, so these are the applications of a jute plant. Okay, so these are cotton and jute are the major fiber crops of the world as well as our country India. Okay, so this is enough about the fiber crops. Shall discuss other details in further classes, maybe about the spices or any other economic botanical part. Okay, so students, please make use of the time. If you have any more doubts in the class, please ask the doubts in the WhatsApp group. Please don't delay the class, don't make the class pending, don't keep the class pending. Please do watch the classes on the same day when they are supposed to be watched. Okay, see you in the next class. Till that, take care, bye bye.